Have you ever wondered how a computer mouse works? Stick around, you're about to find out. If you've ever used a home computer, you've probably spent a lot of time with your hand on the mouse. You already know that when you move the mouse around on your desk, the pointer moves around on the computer screen. But what's really going on inside? While it seems like the mouse has always been there on your home computer, that's not the case. With early computers made for the home, users interacted strictly through text. No Windows, no desktop, no fancy graphic user interface. During these days, the keyboard was the only way to use your machine. In the early 70s, however, researchers at Xerox's Palo Alto Research Center were working on a new way to interact with computers, using a graphical representation of a desktop, where you can move items around. This graphical method of interacting with the computer eventually made its way into Apple computers, and then into other computers, thanks to the introduction of Microsoft's Windows. With this new method of interacting with your machine came the need for a more effective way to move things around in your screen. The old keyboard could only do so much. Thankfully, Douglas Engelbert of the Stanford Research Institute had already built a device that would do the trick. Engelbert's device was a wooden box with rollers underneath that could sense when you were moving the device back and forth. This original device was given the nickname Mouse because the wire connecting the wooden box to the computer resembled a mouse tail. And the nickname stuck. To control their new graphics-based computer, the Xerox team adapted Engelbert's design so that the rollers were inside the mouse, controlled by a rolling ball that moved against the surface of a desktop. These internal rollers control both horizontal and vertical movement across the computer's screen, with the direction and speed of the movement across the computer's screen determined by which direction and how fast the rollers were spun. To select an item, you press a button on top of the mouse. More recently, the mechanical rollers and rolling ball have been replaced by an optical mechanism where a light or a laser is pointed at the desktop, and a sensor tracks the movement in relation to what it sees on your desktop. That's why these new mice don't work well on extremely uniform surfaces. It becomes harder to tell if anything is changing underneath the mouse. These days, mice come in all different shapes and sizes. They've added a variety of buttons, wheels for scrolling, and flashing lights. And now, some mice can even send positional information back to your computer wirelessly. That's right, they've eliminated the wire tail that originally gave the mouse its name. But don't worry, it's still called a mouse. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you soon.